Hi everybody, welcome to Making Australia the Crafter Show, where we're going to be recapping every episode of this season of Making in Australia. I'm crochet artist Chilly Philly, and every week I'm going to be joined by a new fun crafty guest. And this week I'm joined by one of the stars of this season of Making in Australia, the one and only Sai-Wai. Woo!
And I'm spilling the tea.
You're ready.
I'm ready, baby. I'm ready.
So on the show, we didn't get to see much of sort of what your outside of the show sort of practice is. What sort of stuff do you like to do?
I'm really known for my kind of bricolage paper craft work and also my textile based work. And I thought I wanted to paint, but it turns out I didn't. I got introduced to printmaking and sculpture and I went, oh, this is amazing. So that's where that love of paper sort of grew from.
So this week is another mega craft and it is all about invention. And so the challenge is to create an invention that resolves some sort of problem. You obviously didn't make it this far, but what were you planning on doing for your invention?
I kind of went back to the source, which is my obsession with food and stuff like that. So what I was going to make was a beautiful little like marine ply dish drainer that was like a little mountain range, so you could stack your dishes on there and they would drain across some river. I love a river rock. Similar to what I'd done in the bathroom, that river rock sort of thing. And the water would actually drain towards like a little kind of reservoir to collect so that you could grow herbs and little plants. And so you could keep it in your kitchen, do your dishes and water your herbs that you could cook with. So yeah. It was this sort of water cycle because I like the idea of saving water. So that was my plan. So it would have been very small. It was a hard, I think it was a really difficult one. I mean, I don't know what you would have done if you, have you thought about this?
Or maybe an invention I could think of is just some sort of way to immediately dump your clothes into your washing machine. So I don't know, create something, it has to be a top loader, have the basket go at the top, maybe you just stick it all in the basket. Once it gets heavy enough, the trap door falls down, goes into your top loader, close the thing, it washes it, la la la, as opposed to having this very eternally filling washing basket. I don't know. I just thought of that just then. I just put that out of my ass.
That's good. You removed a step. It's like, cut out the middleman.
But yeah, I feel like, you know, if I did that as an idea, you know, I'd make a very nice looking like a nice basket that functions, you know, paint it and make it really fun and, you know, make sure it, you know, serves its purpose. But I would focus strongly on sort of making it a nice, crafty, functioning object. Because I don't know, that's the competition. It's not construct a physical object out of wood and metal competition. I don't know. We've had like so many challenges in a row now that have been construction. I'm here for a craft show.
Yeah, though they have been quite heavily buildy crafts. Well, buildy makes, buildy yeah. build.
Who was your favorite out of the six?
Favorite person?
No. Who is your favorite?
Everyone knows Andrew is my favorite. Like I've said that from day one. I think there's footage of me saying, this is my favorite person. And I stick by that. But I love George. It's very much George. It's beautiful. It's well thought out. There's a sense of fun and play about it. Also, she's so good with materials and paint finishes. She's really, you know, she's a force to be reckoned with. Yes. The other one I really liked was Rizaldi's, yes. Because it did solve a problem and it fits in with his aesthetic as well. So it had his stamp on it, like it looked like a Rizaldi thing. Jax was bonkers, as Jax wants to be. I had a Wallace and Gromit vibe to that one. So I was waiting for the rocket ship and the cheese. Rahana's, I like the idea of. I have actually think she's made better trees personally because she made that really beautiful tree before. Yes. So I didn't think this tree was as beautiful as the other tree that she made that I really loved from that outdoor challenge. Will's was actually really clever. I really like that idea. I think scaling up like that's always really difficult, getting materials right and things like that. Like sometimes it's like, I think with the pressure of that sort of show and that build and trying to get materials right for that, it does add that layer of difficulty to it.
I think we had almost like a scale of, you know, sort of, we had like two peoples who were strictly function. So Andrew and Wills, they were very functional things, but they hadn't sort of done anything further than what they were. And then you have sort of like the people who have strong function and strong aesthetic. So George and Rizaldi's, theirs were sort of functional objects and they were very, very crafty. And then you had the sort of in between of kind of functional, kind of crafty with Jack and Rahana's. And so, yeah, it was just interesting to see such a spectrum. I don't know.
Yeah, it was a three-way. It was like really a three-way split in terms of the way that was done.
Yeah, everybody thought of it in such a specific way, but they also very similar. It was interesting. Yeah. You had mentioned that your favorite person was Andrew, and Andrew actually voluntarily leaves, which is actually very sad because I was rooting for Andrew as well.
And his just attitude to everything is joyful, and he's so open to new experiences, and he knows he doesn't know everything. Like he's just, oh, how do you do that? Or, you know, he's just, yeah, he's a lot of fun. So yeah. I think they're losing a really personality out of that. But I am incredibly proud of him just deciding to take care of himself.
Well, thank you for joining me today. It's been so nice to have somebody who was there.
Seeing you again.
Yeah.
Ages.
And thank you everybody for watching tonight's crafter show. Join me again next week for another episode, and until then, keep crafting. Bye.
Bye.